Hello, dear students. So in this lecture, we'll try to understand the next essay from the first unit. The title of the essay is Memory, the Other Side of Silence. And this essay is written by Urvashi Gutalia. You know, memory means smruti, atvanitla goshti, atvan, you know. So the first, we should try to understand about Urvashi Gutalia, who was born in the city of Ambala in Haryana state. So she belongs to Haryana, Urvashi Gutalia, and she is a feminist writer. And actually, she has taken her education from South Asian studies from University of London, and she also started her academic career with Oxford University Press in Delhi. Okay. She is a famous writer, and she has written on gender and gender means linga bhed. Okay, communalism means dharmik vaad ahe to, and fundamentalism means mudbhut vaad or mulatattva vaad, and media like areas. So in these, she writes about all such type of areas. And her writings have appeared in several newspapers, magazines, and publications. So she is a type of journalist. Okay. So the present essay, Memory, is taken from Gutalia's book, The Other Side of Silence. So the title of the essay is Memory, and this essay is taken from the book, The Other Side of Silence, which is written by Urvashi Gutalia. This book, The Other Side of Silence, is about the partition of India. And this is most important book, which tells us about the traumatic influences of partition of the Indian subcontinent of the country of India over the societies. So how partition affected the people of India, and now actually all Indian people, though they are living in Pakistan now. So the people living in Indian continent, how this partition affected them. And in this, this book is more than a history. So this is not only the history of partition. This is more than history, than a memoir. It is not only a memoir. It means, this is not a, just like atman mun nahi hai, memoir mun nahi hai, that this is something different, something more than that, what we see. So which reflects the worst reminiscences and recollections of horror and painful experiences. So horror of partition, painful experiences of partition experienced by both now Indians and Pakistan. Okay, so silence and speech, memory and forgetting, and pain and healing, these are at the heart of this book. So the memories of partition, they are so horrible that the victims, victims म्हणजे जे त्याला बळी पडलेले आहेत, ज्यांनी partition स्वतः अनुभवलेलं आहे, असे जे लोक आहेत त्यांच्या मनामध्ये ज्या आठवणी आहेत त्या खूप हॉरिबल आहेत. But they can't forget them, and forgetting as well as recollecting, or memory and forgetting, both is difficult, and both is not possible. Okay, pain and healing. So pain of the partition, what they experienced during the partition, that pain, that vedana, tiji vedana ahe, tiji dukkha ahe, te visarta yet nahi. And healing is also very difficult. Te visarna ani tya zakhma bharun kadna hi ek kathin gosht ahe, asa Urvashi Gutalia yachyamadhye mhante. So with the help of this essay, Urvashi Gutalia shows us the bitter experiences which still haunt and pierce those who turned up the victim, worst victim of partition, means the people je bali padlele ahet partition la, those are they are called as victim mhanje bhaksha, bali, victim of partition. And those memories, very bitter experiences, the things happened during partition are very horrible, very violent. Okay? They still haunt. Still means after how many years partition happened in 1947. Still those memories, that violence, that those experiences still haunt the people after 50 or more than 70 years. Today we say that. So 50, 70 years, or you know, when this essay was written, maybe 50 years later, we find the experiences or the memories are still in the mind of the people and they are haunting. They are not letting them to live healthy life or good life. Okay, partition was difficult to forget. It's very difficult. The people who experienced, who lived during that period, who experienced that experience, that incident, ज्यांनी तो प्रत्यक्ष अनुभवला, एक्सपिरियन्स केलेला आहे, पार्टिशन मध्ये जे काही घडलं, ज्या दंगली घडल्या, ज्याला ते सामोरे गेलेले आहेत, अशा लोकांना त्या मेमरीज, त्या आठवणी, त्या कटू आठवणी विसरणं शक्य नाहीये असं रायटर म्हणते. दे वेर कॉम्पेल्ड टू लोकेट अँड डिसलोकेट बिटवीन द टू डिवायडेड नेशन्स. वी नो दॅट वेन पार्टिशन हॅपन्ड, पार्टिशन ऑफ इंडिया अँड टू नेशन्स वी आर क्रिएटेड, भार इंडिया अँड पाकिस्तान. सो द मुस्लिम्स फ्रॉम India, they were to compelled to leave India and go to live in Pakistan. And the area which we call now Pakistan, though the Hindu people living in that area, they were compelled to leave that area, is now today's Pakistan, and they were compelled to leave or to go to the India particularly. So how the people, you know, they migrated to both the countries, people from Pakistan, Hindu people from Pakistan migrated to India, and Muslim people from India migrated to Pakistan. Actually, before partition, all were Indians only. All were living in the same society, same village, same place. But now, the division created this division. It was not the division only, the division of the region. It was not the division on the map only. But that division was created in the mind of the people. It was created in the society, in the minds. So it was very horrible. And the result of that partition, even today we find that, you know, the bitter, you know, the minds or the, you know, the things happening even today. Or we say that the dangali ghatat aajhi, Muslim, Hindu Muslim madhe je phut padli jate, the dangali ghatat, the sagalyancha mulashi hi partition kute tari karanibhut aahe. So we can't forget that partition. Okay. So as the victim of partition, one cannot forget those horrible suffering, pain, and you know, confusion. Okay. So this essay, this memory is the essay that deals with the most sensitive issue of the nation's division, what we call partition, into two sub-nations, India and Pakistan. But is well known by the entire world for the cost. No, we know the entire world knows that the how the society or the nation, our nation, paid the cost for it, the sacrifice made by the people of both Pakistan and India now, who belonged to one country before the partition, but who paid the sacrifice for this division. You know, particularly women and children, they faced a lot of, you know, you know, crime and violence and you know, sexual abuse. Also, many of the women were raped during the partition. Children were killed, and you know, very, you know, horrible and cruel things happened during the partition. So we all are well aware of the ways through which the country was divided, and there is little doubt that in the history of partition, the stories of women, children, scheduled castes, low caste people and many others have been silenced. But what we find today, that they are silenced. The stories of the partition are silenced. They are not given voice by the government as well as at the level of history writing also. So when there comes the thing of history writing, these children or particularly women, their voice is, you know, silenced. What they felt, what violence they faced, what pain they faced, is not given voice, or it is not talked about even in the history of India. It is not depicted what children or women felt or what they faced or how they sacrificed is not written in the history of India. When we read the history of India, so we do not read voice of women and children, what they felt during this partition. sexual violence has always been associated with war. When there are wars in the world, we find that women are sexually abused, and their voice is, you know, is not given voice actually. So one more thing, that on the way of their migration, the people experienced horrible pain and met with hunger and homelessness. They were compelled to leave their home, and they became homeless when the people from Pakistan came to India, and people from India, because of their, you know, religion, they were made to leave the countries, and they experienced horrible pain. So a partition not only divided nation, but also people from the same country, same place, same soil, same town, and same village were divided. And social values were broken, law and order was weakened, and it was only the partition responsible for all pain and pain we as a nation and society experienced and witnessed. So it was only the partition which was very horrible, and it made the people sacrifice their lives and sacrifice everything. Mrs. Bhutani actually has realistically pursued that pain, and she has written this essay and expressed her serious concern with the victims of partition, and especially women and children, particularly how they became victim of partition. Bhutani writes about them, and she has also written about the worst situation they encountered or they faced. So she successfully recollects all that was part of division and means partition, and she extends her homage to all those who lost their lives due to violence or partition by preserving their literal, visible, invisible existence. The people who were killed during the partition. So Bhutalia tana shraddhanjali dete hai isse madhe, and the people who were alive, tancha voice, tancha awaz जो आहे, जो दाबला गेलेला आवाज आहे, अशा बळी पडलेल्या पार्टिशनला, जे बळी पडले त्या लोकांचा, प्रामुख्याने विमेन अँड चिल्ड्रनचा तो आवाज त्यांना देण्याचा ती प्रयत्न करते. सो अनडाऊटेडली दे ऑल डिझर्व टू हॅव देअर रिस्पेक्ट विथ नो कन्सर्न विथ वेअर डीड दे बिलॉंग, इंडिया ऑर पाकिस्तान. मग ते लोक पाकिस्तानचे असू देत आत्ता किंवा इंडियामध्ये राहत असू देत, जे कोणी या पार्टिशनला बळी पडलेले आहेत त्यांच्या भावना समजून घेतल्या, आपण समजून घेतल्या पाहिजेत, आणि त्यांचा जो आवाज दाबला गेला आहे इतिहासामध्ये त्यांच्या आवाजाला महत्व दिलं गेलेलं नाहीये, त्यांच्या वेदना दाबल्या गेलेल्या आहेत, तर त्याला आवाज कुठेतरी, त्याला कुठेतरी वाचा फोडली पाहिजे असं भुटालियाला वाटतंय. आणि त्यांच्या आवाजाला, त्यांच्या वेदनेला आणि त्यांच्या मनामध्ये, यु नो, जे काही दुःख आहे, जे काही हॉरिबल स्मृती आहे पार्टिशनची, त्याला वाचा फोडण्याचं काम भुटालिया या एसेच्या माध्यमातून करण्याचा प्रयत्न करते. So here the writer successfully attempted to safeguard the refugee survivors, means the partitions, victims of partition, and for their well-being. And then they चांगलं जीवन दिलं गेलं पाहिजे, त्यांनी जो जे काही सहन केलं त्याचा विचार आपण आज केला पाहिजे. आणि त्यात ते जे सायलेंट, त्यांच्या मनामध्ये जे सायलेन्स आहे ती खूप भयानक आहे, ना ते विसरू शकतात, आठवणीत ठेवणं देखील भयानक आहे, आणि विसरणं देखील शक्य नाही. अशा कात्रीत सापडलेले हे लोक आहेत, अशा कन्फ्युजन मध्ये असलेले हे लोक आहेत, आणि त्यांना कुठेतरी वाचा करून त्यांना न्याय दिला पाहिजे, आणि त्यासमोरे त्यांच्या आवाजाला कुठेतरी जागा दिली पाहिजे असं बुटालियाला वाटते. सो इन दिस वे वी कॅन फाइंड दॅट द रायटर डज नॉट फॉरगेट टू रिमाइंड द गव्हर्नमेंट अँड द सोसायटी द रिस्पेक्टिव्ह ड्युटीज. तो याच्या माध्यमातून गव्हर्नमेंटला देखील किंवा समाजाला देखील की त्यांचं काय कर्तव्य आहे, जे पार्टिशनला बळी पडलेल्या लोकांच्या विषयी आपलं काय कर्तव्य आहे ते सांगण्याचा प्रयत्न, एक मानवतावादी प्रयत्न जो आहे, आणि त्यांचे हक्क जे आहेत त्या हक्कांचं संरक्षण करण्याचा प्रयत्न किंवा त्यांचे हक्क त्यांना मिळवून देण्याचा प्रयत्न एसेच्या माध्यमातून रायटर करण्याचा प्रयत्न करते आहे. सो दिस एसे इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट एसे विच इज रिलेटेड टू द लाईफ ऑफ ऑर द पीपल ऑर द विक्टिम्स ऑफ पार्टिशन पर्टिक्युलरली, अँड विच मेक्स अस अंडरस्टँड द सिच्युएशन ऑर द ट्रू सिच्युएशन of these people, And we also try to think about these victims of partition when we read this essay, okay, we start here.